Hunt Down the Freeman demo has just been released. It was released earlier on today. And I made a podcast about this a few weeks ago, talking about some of the implications of the game and, you know, the price that they were asking for on Indiegogo and other legal aspects. So you can go and listen to that. I'll link it in the top right-hand corner, or the left-hand corner, or wherever, but you'll be able to listen to that. So we're just going to play through this demo. Just like the Black Forest demo we played a few weeks ago, we're going to be, you know, just reviewing this also as a demo, but also as, you know, the gameplay. Is it suitable as a demo? Does it do well as a demo? And I'll be reviewing this like I review any other, you know, mods. It's going to be no different. I'm not going to treat this any differently. Now, beforehand, there was kind of a, you know, a clip, like last time on Hunt Down the Freeman, I believe it said, and it was basically just stuff in the advert. So you can go and watch the advert, but we'll just get straight into this.
Where is Gordon? Oh, where is the free man?
I don't know.
Alright, so I think we're in game here. We're at least getting up. Right, there we are. So the HUD colour is blue. We currently are doing fine for frame rate. I thought it was a bit shaky, but we're fine now. Okay, so let's see what we've got here. So obviously they're looking for the free man. Although I do believe it's only Vortigaunts that say the free man, but I could be wrong. I should do like chopping up the melon. Whoa.
You'd better run. There's nothing else you can do here.
Okay.
But one kindness isn't enough to erase all the sins. Freeman must die.
Okay, so it's actually a machete. So this is the person who died at the start of Half-Life. I still don't know if they should be using stuff from the actual Half-Life game, and if they've got in contact with Valve about that. But hey-ho. Want to keep going. Okay, so we're going into another cutscene or something. I have no idea. Something bad's gonna happen, I just know it. Nope.
Good memories. It's hard to see them these days.
Alright, so out here's looking, you know, pretty good, I guess. At least better than in here so far. But I mean, I don't know how detailed sewers should actually be. Oh, what's going on here? Alright, so none of these work. And I am stuck. So where are we going? Keeping on going, I guess. It's a lovely particle effect here. Ah, now, a lever.
It's not working.
Okay, power. Well, it's obviously up there. It's very well, clearly, you know, marked. It's not like it's not well marked. We know where to go, but we just need to find out how to get there. How do we get there? Obviously not this way. So as I said with the demo we played a few weeks ago, I don't know if this is like actually part of the game or if this is just the demo. You know what I mean. So yeah, we just need to look for Wayne. Is there... Now, are we actually going to be able to make it up here? Come on! Just die already. Maybe we're going to need a third box. What was that up there? Did you see that? Did anyone else see that? What is that? There's something going on up there. I don't know. Right, steady the boxes! Ah, this looks like it's probably the way. Nope. That isn't actually the way. Oh, come on! That's... I've said many times that, you know, the solution to each problem or puzzle has to be blindingly obvious for the player. You know, because not all players are like, you know, the map designers. They don't know any of the tricks or anything. And that wasn't very blindingly obvious, especially for one of the very first puzzles of the demo. I'm just saying, that's just first criticism. Press V. What's adrenaline? Oh, it's like the adrenaline you get out of that fat lot of good that was. It's kind of like Left 4 Dead, but not really. Okay, anything here, right? And now we can open this and get out here, but we want to be moving on this way. It's got six zombies here, two of which are preoccupied. Now, I could have turned that thing on and killed them if I'd noticed it. I didn't notice it, but I do see now that there is well, that's an interesting thing. It's got one of these things here. It's got a Lambda logo there. All right, come on, guys. Oh, gee. I'm suspecting the values have been changed of these enemies. Maybe not. Right, there we go. So props for putting this thing here. You can only use it once. Now, is there a cache? Maybe that's what that was. Was that what the Lambda cache was? Probably, right. Or unless it's behind here. Ah, now there are, you know, health pots here. Oh! Oh, gee. More zombies getting mad. Come on, have at it, yeah. Now take him out. Flippy heck, that was one heck of a jump scare. Oh, come on! I don't have all day to fight zombies! Yeah, don't put this many zombies in, especially if you've only got a machete. I mean, if you had a gravity gun or something like that, surely you'd be able to pick up these and kill them and exploding barrels and all that, but the fact you've only got a machete, or, well, yeah, the equivalent of a crowbar, don't put, like, six zombies in. Right, let's keep going. I'm just checking if that door was obvious, because I hadn't noticed it until then. But it is if you search around. It's not like completely hidden, so that that's good. Right. Can you interact with this person and get a funny little cut scene? All right. Okay, we've got two zombies in here. Right, we're gonna go down here and do this room first. Okay, we've got three zombies. Any easy way of killing them this time? Ah! Oh, flip! That didn't quite work out how I wanted it to. No! Oh, come on, you must be kidding me. You have to be kidding. You are joking. Okay, I forgot to kill the barnacle because I was so overcome by what was going on. No idea what happened and where all these zombies came from. So, never mind. We'll try that again. I was going to see if I could get them to run into the barnacles on the other side. That's like the most strategical thing that you could do. Is use the other enemies, because in the map we played yesterday, you saw that the zombies ran into the barnacles, both of them, and that was, you know, easy way of killing them. And if we've only got a machete, you're looking for unique ways of getting the zombies. So, oh come on, he didn't even get caught by one, right? So this guy's difficult because he's got a grenade. This is so difficult. Well, difficult as in with this machete. I don't know how this machete has been implemented, if it's just like same damage as the crowbar. Alright, this guy hopefully will go and blow himself up. Yep. That's exactly what happened. That's what we were hoping would happen. How many of these guys are there? Well, three obviously. And again, he'll just kill himself. Hey! I was always very curious about them in the Half-Life games. Right. And another guy. Surprise, surprise. Oh, 44 HP. Fighting with this thing is awfully difficult. Ah, but there's some health. That's decent. 34. Gee, not an awful lot. Right, anything around here? Any hidden goodies? Nope. Anything in here? Doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like we want to be going down there. Let's keep going. Right. So now we come to a few valves. Now, what do these valves do? You see, there's no easy way of actually... Whoa, gee. Did you see that? Yeah, there's no easy way of getting through here without... Ew. Well, we could have got caught and then hit them all. But not... we didn't do that. Alright, so that's what that thing does. So what did these two valves do then? We'll go and try the valves. Right. And here is number two. Or, well, said number three, but it's the second one returning. So what did this actually do? Did that thing turn on? So I'm guessing we could jump down there now, yeah? I mean, why else would you turn it on? Right. Is it filling up? I don't know what on earth happened there, but never mind. Right, so we'll go back to the top floor. Right, there we go, got him. You must be kidding me. Right, up we go. What does this do? Don't know, doesn't it? It's not a button, but it's lit up like one. I guess that'll just be the same thing, so that's what opened that door. So now we can go in here. What is in this room? So I presume that's what we turned on, maybe. I don't know. Anything up here? Ah, there we go. So what are we actually doing? I don't know. Don't know. Right, we'll just move on. Oh, there's two Combine soldiers there. I don't know how I managed to open that. We'll quickly get them. There is some thing coming down. Don't know what. Right, there we go. I think it's decontamination. So we'll keep going. Oh, there we go. Ah. I don't know how we're supposed to deal with this guy. I guess we're not. I guess we're just supposed to jump. Are we just supposed to try and jump that? I see these things aren't fully on the floor. But hey, what's that to do with anything? We want to get through this and beat it. Right, we're going to jump. I'm saving it. I'm quick saving it. Ah, so that is actually possible, right. I actually had my doubts completely. I thought we were just going to fall down there, but obviously not. Right. Now we need to get from here to here, dodging the barnacle, which we did. Now we need to get from here to there. Now that's going to be super difficult. Yet we still did it. I just have to say, all of these jumps aren't very obvious. They could maybe be made a bit more clearer in terms of, you know, what you're actually trying to achieve. Just slightly though, it's not like a big thing. Okay, so you can go that way. Can you go this way? Nope. Can you go anywhere here? So I presume they're just all part of the same prop. Oh dear, someone. Ah, this is where we were before, right. Oh, darn it. We don't have any other weapons! This is the worst combat system I've seen in a long time. I've just got to come out and say that. Like, if you're gonna give someone a machete, make sure they can at least swing quicker than this. There's like a left click to it, but it's no quicker. Okay, so it looks like I can do that, and that's the quickest you're gonna get. I don't know if that's deliberate, but I'm guessing it's not. And yeah, that's still not effective enough. Oh, eventually, right, 44 HP. Gee, blackhead crabs. Die. I don't know, I think they saved the game there. If we had a gravity gun, we'd be able to sort this. Right, there we go. Oh. Okay, this guy does quite a lot of damage. Oh. This is the slowest combat I've... You see, it's almost impossible to use this left click because the zombies swing much quicker, so I don't know why you'd ever need to use this right click rather. I might have said left click. Eventually, right, let's go and get some health. Still one more guy, obviously. Any health? No, no, there's not. That's a joy. Any health anywhere? This is really off-putting having this round. I'm not going to lie. If I was designing a game, I'd actually make visibility better when you're... I know many other games do it, but I'm not a fan of any of the games that do it. It's not... Whoa, did he just go right through that wall? All right. Okay, we'll save the game there. I just want to go back and check one thing over here. We'll probably be back here anyway. The zombie managed to like walk right into the wall. Now look, there's like a love heart on it. FreeRGW. Oh, so much clutter. It's unreal, right? Fast zombies are fast. Now, there's no way I'm getting past them with the combat system. Alright. God mode is on. I hope. You see, yeah, the right click is good. It's more, you know, overpowered. Or, yeah, you know what I mean. But it's not actually... You know, it's not effective against zombies who swing much faster than it. So, yeah. Anything here?
Captain. Captain, can you read me?
Nick?
Captain, thank God. We lost communication with our squad at the combines. Oscar's on the way with the backup. Whatever you do, be careful.
So it took quite a wee while to get round here.
Captain Mitchell, Freeman is not here. We are under heavy fire. Allied Combine forces are dead. Mike and George are dead. Joe and I are wounded.
Something's supposed to be happening.
Captain. It's been an honor.
Oh God. They'll pay for that.
Who's talking? I have no idea who is talking here. Right, let's move on. I'm presuming we don't want to be in the water, as it's probably electrified. I'm just saving every step of the way. Right, we got him. And we got him eventually. Right, health would be nice. Alright, so this is... right. I know where we are now. Back at this area again, which is good. I guess it's good, the good use of space. Always go on about the good use of space, and this is one of them. Okay, we're now on the second map. This flashing is really bad. Okay, so we need to find a valve or whatever you call it. So it could be in a number of places, probably behind one of these things. Okay, so we'll just keep breaking these. They'll be here somewhere. Ah, there it is. Right at the very corner. Right, let's pick it up. No, let's pick it up. There we go. I don't think you need to put a blue circle on it. Or a blue environment. Right. So, here we go. There we go, it's ended. Did it do anything to this? No, it didn't. Just this, right. How did that know I had gone through? What's going on here? Alright, are we eventually going to get our hands on some guns? We just collected something. Maybe it was ammo or something, I don't know. Ah, there we go. Gee, look at this view model, it's bouncing about the place. Ah, there we go, some... flip. So that fires the grenade. Okay, right, so... let's test the guns out then. Hopefully there'll be some... nice enemies to test the guns out on. Hopefully. Maybe some combine. Ah, maybe... there's just like a shooting range here. I can barely see the crosshair, to be honest. Inferno boiler. Do remember we are still on God mode here, because there is not really very much health, but there is now. I think the the colours, the blue and the red, they're just too dark, basically. I think orange is a good colour. Or yellow. Maybe not bright yellow, obviously. But I'm not sure about this, blue and green. I also don't like the view model, not going to lie. Just keep the view model as straight as possible. I know in Half-Life it's slightly moving, I think, but it's not noticeable. I don't know what's the view model like in Half-Life 2. I have no idea, but it's not as much as this. I don't know, maybe give the option to change it. That's what I would do. I don't know how easy that is to code in, for that matter. Alright. We've turned God mode off, because I have health, and, here I am, so... Alright, so can we open these? Because it says some lambda thing around here. Maybe it's through the door. Maybe that's where we're going.
Bring it on.
Okay, we had a bit of lag there. Door just closes randomly. There's a light shining from somewhere. There's a vent probably behind. There's no vent. Ah, but there is one of these things here. Don't know what they are. Right. Now we need to get up there. What are we actually doing here? What? Are you serious? I literally just got up there and I probably cut a lot of bits out there because that was just took me way too long. How are you supposed to actually do this? Oh, come on. Right, we've got that thing. We can now stand on this. I don't know why it didn't. Sometimes it does latch on, sometimes it doesn't. Now, eventually. Hallelujah, we're out. More health, always decent. So I presume we're supposed to be firing at these guys. What? 13 HP, jeez. Where's he firing from? What was that? What's going on? Why are the people so close to you? Combat should never be that, I should never be able to run up there like that. Oh, you must be kidding me. What kind of combat's this? Don't have the player running up to him like that, shooting him down. Make it so there's a gap between. Hmm. This is frustrating to say the least. Not because it's just difficult outright and I'm bad, because it's just the way it's been designed, is the fact that they can run right up to you. See, they're running right up to me now. Like, at least you could let the player run into the area and search for kind of, or get familiar with the area. But now, as we run in, there's like a guy up there with a gun. Do we have a grenade we could throw up there? Yeah, of course it does that. But we got someone at least. Gee, he shoots immediately. Alright, 6 HP. Yeah, like, I don't know if you probably couldn't camp there, but like, give the player a sense of their surroundings first time. Music's a bit too loud. And of course we have to do that all over again. Well, that didn't quite go how I planned. Oh, we've got no more. Yeah, with two of them, it's just way too difficult. Alright, 52. I've saved it now. There's no turning back. And of course, we got the ladder to stop us from getting completely annihilated by this guy. But there's two guys, they haven't noticed me. Which one should I go for? Yeah, of course, of course. How am I not going up that ladder? Like, am I even at the head here? Actually seems like this gun's more effective. Yeah. Lots of barrels stacked up in a row, or well, not stacked up, but you know what I mean. Right, we're on 100 HP. Yeah, this music's getting irritating. Please stop. Please. Alright, it did stop. Thank goodness for that. I mean, it is difficult to script music, I'm not gonna lie. It's funny how, like, you don't get any health and then all the health comes at the same time. Whoa, are they firing at me? Well, of course they are. Whoa. So what do we do now? Now we've got this thing here. Yeah, were we supposed to do something here? Okay, so that's going to there, and that's going down to here. So that's going into there. That's... So how do we turn this thing on then? I'm not sure. No idea. So have we not found out a way to open these doors? Okay, so there is something up here. And that turns to green, and you know, I'm honestly still not sure what it does. Someone shouts "Bring It On," the name of that movie about cheerleading, I believe. What's going on with this door? And it's like, I don't know.
Bring it on.
Yes. He keeps shouting "Bring it on," but I've no idea why. Oh, come on, right, this is open now. Yeah. That's not very obvious what you do at all. Like, where that thing connects to and this thing connects to, and even just where the lever is, it's not obvious. It's like very bad design. I would get that looked at. Got a lovely kitchen here. Oh, Till. I wonder if they're having a lot of the money.
It's been an honor.
Who said that? Where is he? This magical guy talking. Hello? Maybe that was me talking, I'm not sure.
Bring it on.
Anybody in the toilets, like... It's like a toilet floating, actually. Floating toilet. What's blocking me here? Alright, let's keep going. Oh, so it's not that way then.
Bring it on. Bring it on.
I can barely hear what he's saying. So he asked me to kill him. I killed him. What is going on there? There's like orange in the floor or something. So I actually clip through here. It actually looks like you can go this way. That you can actually walk down here. I mean, there's no way of getting in. I couldn't find any, you know, buttons or anything. But this bit's actually like a proper running thing. Whoa, we're getting dragged into fire. Why not have the grenades as a separate... as a separate thing, right? I mean, surely that'd be much more logical. I don't know. Alright, now we go through here.
Bring it on.
If we can. Oh, flip. So it doesn't look like you can actually get into here at all. For some reason. You should just be able to jump in there, right? Well, maybe if we can't get out, we can't get in. It does look like you can get in. But the thing is, you can't. Maybe it was just a gun, I'm not entirely sure. The stupid red things round about. Right, I'll go and I'm gonna try battle on to the end here. I'm gonna try and battle on and get there. And we've got antlions! Whoa, they can actually get through there! Way where there was never a way here, right? Right? Why is the gun blue? Oh, that's crazy. It actually looks cooler like that color. Alright, so we've got a wire and the wire leads somewhere. Maybe not. But there's a wire though. It just leads over there and ends. So there's lots of goodies to pick up. Ah, battery. That's placed very strategically. What the heck is this? Oh, it's one of these interaction things from the beginning that should have probably been in it more. If, you know, it's a thing. Hello. Is that a cremator? I did mention that in my podcast. I wonder what they're doing. Oh, it's getting cremated. I'm completely missing out on the narrative here. Like, I know these guys were the guys who got burned by the cremator against this wall, like, ah, but, like, oh, seriously? Ah. Sneaky. Ah. Not a heart. What the heck? Gee. Hey guys, I think it might be bugged. Do you get it? No, okay. My humor is once again wasted. How is this still on? Like, what kind of Bluetooth technology is this? Why is there music playing while I'm trying to have my adventure? Wait, is this guy alive or dead? Oh. Who knows? Yeah, like most mods, the music and voice acting in this one isn't very good at all. These outlines stop for nothing. Go away. Go away. We need to see how my thingy is doing. Let's go. Door that was locked is now no longer locked. Nothing behind there. Always check these cabinets in any mod. I mean, if you place them, I'm gonna break them. Oh wait, they're not zombies. Wait, did I just see the G-Man there? I just saw a figure, but maybe that was... Oh, it's just the sand line. Yeah, is the G-Man even making an appearance in this one? Oh wait, there's nothing. Alright, I guess that's fine. There's nothing wrong with having rooms with nothing in them. Guess it's just got one, another one of these. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with having rooms. It's always good to explore. Do these things do anything? Doesn't look like it. Right, so we can go up or down. I think we're going to want to go up. That's where we're going to want to go. Because we've been down already. Come on. This is the worst place for the battle. Come up the stairs and immediately get attacked by a dozen or so antlions. Yeah. Don't do that in your mods. Don't have endless antlions attack you unless you're standing on sand. No, not even if you're standing on sand, just don't have endless antlions. Okay, so... Right. Do we have to go down there? What has happened to my gun? I mean, I would be using the crowbar or the melee version, which obviously here we have a machete, but it's just too difficult to use, right? I was going to push the buttons and jump out just in case there was like a glitch or it was going to trick us, but it didn't. This is literally where we just were, right, okay. It did take me a while to figure that one out. Ah. I'm not gonna say that wasn't obvious, I guess it was slightly obvious. I don't know what it does though. Hopefully powers the elevator. Or opens the door. Either elevator or door. Good, it is the door. Whoa, what happened there? What is going on, mate? Oh, this guy's having trouble using the machete as well. Yeah, I know, that's what it's like using it. That was pretty cool. I quite liked that, I'm not gonna lie. Not the rest of the cutscene, just the fact he chopped this and the guy's head got clamped down upon. Right. Alright, looks like my guns have gone. Are you kidding me? You cannot be serious. Like, no, seriously. My guns have gone. Flip. Where did my guns go? Alright, looks like we're gonna have to stand our ground against this guy. Here I am. Yeah, that fight was awful. I'm on the way with backup. We will be there ASAP.
Alright. I'll find a way to get to the rooftop. See you there.
Okay, so is it possible to pile stuff up? It probably is. That's probably what we're supposed to do, but what I don't understand is why would you take away their guns with no explanation? And how the heck are we supposed to... to explode these without completely... Oh, well, there they are. Get some health at least behind here. Was that it? Alright, that was way too loud. I'm not gonna lie, that was awful. So is that what happened then? Like a thing came through the roof and killed. Well, it didn't kill me obviously. Like, what now? There we go. Right, give me your gun. I right that happened. I right I did that. I right born.
Where is Gordon?
All right. Oh, here we are at the start again.
I don't know.
Speak, you bastard.
Go to hell.
Captain.
Wow.
Captain. Captain, calm down. We've already lost too many men. Maybe we should just let the Combine handle this. Maybe.
Yeah, you may as well.
No. The hunt has only just begun.
No, just give up. Okay, thank you, Birkin Dennis Yaren. I don't know how to pronounce that. Thank you to Alex Lee and all these other people who I'm not going to call out one at a time. Thank you to Vincent Fallow. Thank you to all these other people. I'll just keep saying thank you. Don't know why. Special thanks to Valve, of course you've got to. Philip Marlowe, of course you've got to include Philip there for doing it. What about me? Why not thank me for giving you some, you know, advertisement through the podcast and playtesting your game? Well, not even playtesting, just playing it and putting up with it. Okay, so now there's Vortigaunts.